A few years ago, Brackeys was the number one YouTube channel when it came to Unity tutorials, but it closed up shop when the owner, Asbjørn Thursland, wanted to move on to bigger and better things. But even today, when you search for Unity tutorials, you get a whole host of Brackeys videos. I'm going to be looking at the last series of tutorials created on the Brackeys channel, which is not actually about Unity at all. It's a C-sharp programming tutorial. It's called How to Program in C-sharp, and it's meant as a primer on the language before you hop into Unity. I think this is an excellent idea, and it's exactly what I did back when I was first learning myself nearly a decade ago. Trying to learn about C-sharp at the same time as you're trying to learn about Unity can be really overwhelming, so it's a good idea to do it one by one. But I can tell you now that while it does a good job of explaining things, this tutorial is missing a lot of stuff that anyone learning C-sharp, in particular those who want to make games with Unity, should at least be exposed to. That's why leaving aside the introductory video in the series, which covers how to set up a development environment in VS Code, I'll be giving a brief review of each video and pointing out all of the things that it does well and the things that are missing before concluding with my overall opinion and recommendation. Let's begin with the video on basics. It jumps right into writing a console application, which is a great place to start learning how to code since it's as simple as things can get. The tutorial gets straight to the point and doesn't waste your time. I'd have liked to see him explain in a little bit more detail about the concept of libraries and the fact that a lot of programming is just making use of code that other people have already written. That's exactly what the Unity game engine is, and indeed the same goes for the syntax in the C-sharp programming language. I feel like it would give the viewer a little bit more context as to why the instructions they're giving the computer actually work. The next video is on variables, an extremely important subject for anyone who wants to learn to code. I really like the container metaphor he uses for variable assignment. Some people say that anyone who struggles with variables is not cut out to be a programmer, but I disagree. I think the equal sign syntax can really trip you up when you're first learning. Brackeys does a great job explaining this visually in a way that anyone can understand. I was surprised when he said that it's okay to have numbers at the end of your variable names.
And I'm gonna call it number one. It's okay to have numerics inside of a variable name as long as you start with a letter.
I think he meant the compiler was okay with it, but the problem is that the people just learning to code watching this tutorial might think that it's a good practice. It's not. You should try and use descriptive variable names where possible. At the end, he asks you to write a program as a challenge, which is a really good idea and repeats itself later in the series as well. It gives you a chance to test your knowledge. The problem is that he kind of glosses over the syntax for doing the math required, and I think that understanding basic math operators is crucial to programming anything, so it would have been nice to have a little bit more detail on these and how to use them. The other big flaw I noticed is that he doesn't really cover the concept of variable scope at all, which can lead to a lot of frustration because you might not understand why the code that you've written is not working. The fourth episode is about conditionals. He covers if statements, comparison operators, and Boolean operators. It also covers switch statements right at the end, which is a good example of the kind of thing you might not use right away, but it's good to have in your knowledge bank because eventually it'll be the right tool for the job. It would have been nice to see him talk about switch statement fall through and the purpose of the break keyword so that people are not left wondering why it exists. Next up, we have loops. He covers for loops and while loops, but not do while loops, which would have been nice to know about, but honestly, I think it's fine because they're not used all that often. The Brackeys tutorial did a great job explaining for loop syntax. It can be a little bit overwhelming when you're first learning it, and I'm glad he took the time to explain every little thing that's involved. Also, thanks for showing off the autocomplete feature. I once worked with a programmer who avoided using for loops because he didn't like writing them out by hand each time, and he didn't know about autocomplete. Yeah, don't be that guy. But anyway, loops are one of those things that you really should play around with on your own to expand your understanding. There's a lot going on, and iteration is a powerful tool if you know how to use it right. Episode 5 is about arrays, and it covers both arrays and lists. I would have liked to see a mention of multidimensional arrays and jagged arrays, even if it's just an offhand note that they exist and what they are. He glosses over generics, which I think is a mistake, since they're a very powerful tool and relatively common as well. Also, since this video is about collections in general, some other useful ones like dictionaries might have been at least worth mentioning. The second to last episode is about methods. He covers what a method is, how to define one, how to call it, and how to give it input and output. Glad to see that he mentions that the words method and function refer to the same concept in C#. It can be confusing when people use different names for the same thing when you don't know that they're the same, especially if you're trying to look for help online. Nice to see that he introduces the modulus operator here as well. because it's useful in a lot of situations and has a weird syntax that might need some introduction. I'd like to see some mention of the ref and out keywords, especially since Unity's raycast function relies on the latter. The final video is about classes. He covers class definition and instantiation, as well as constructors, instance variables, static variables, and access modifiers. I'd have liked to see a mention of the this keyword, since there are times when you'll want to get a reference to the object within itself. Since this is also the video about creating your own data structures, maybe he should have talked about structs as well. This would have been a good opportunity to discuss reference versus value types, which is another major concept that's not covered in any of the tutorials. If you don't know about it, then sometimes code that looks like it should work a particular way just won't, and you'll have no idea why. Oh, and some mention of inheritance and polymorphism would have been nice, considering C# is an object-oriented programming language, and writing Unity model behaviors also involves inheritance. All in all, the presentation in the Brackeys How to Program in C# tutorial is fantastic. It's tightly edited with informative graphics, and the host, Asbjorn, is enthusiastic and enjoyable to listen to. I also really like how he gives little challenges at the end of each episode to get the viewer to try learning things on their own.
Now, I of course want to give you a challenge to complete before the next video. This challenge is going to be to take the average of three numbers.
Nice to see that, because ultimately, even with all the instructions in the world, you'll need to be able to do it yourself at some point. That said, I think the variety of subjects covered in the tutorial series is a little bit lacking. It covers the bare basics, but is missing things that, in my view, are really useful to at least know about before you jump into a complex game engine like Unity. For example, I'd like to see more detail about generics and at least some mention of delegates. Both of these are very useful language features in a variety of cases. If you're wondering, by the way, delegates let you assign functions to variables as long as the function matches the signature of the delegate, and generics allow you to write code that can be used for varying types of objects. By the way, knowing about these things, even if you don't know how to use them, is still beneficial, because one day you'll run into a situation where it's the perfect tool for the job, but you'll only come up with the idea of using it in the first place if you actually know about it. Two other things you should definitely brush up on if you decide to use this tutorial series are variable scope and the difference between reference and value types. He pretty much doesn't cover these at all, and they're very important to know, even more so than the other stuff that I just mentioned earlier. If you don't understand these, you can easily run into a wall where the code just doesn't work properly for reasons that you know nothing about. The third concept that I think you absolutely must be exposed to before starting with Unity is polymorphism and inheritance. Unity is an object-oriented game engine, and when you author scripts, you'll often be inheriting from classes that are built into the engine's library. Having an understanding of this topic will allow you to better grasp concepts like game objects and mono behaviors, components, and scriptable objects. Finally, this is not a C# language concept, but it would have been nice to show people how to debug code and resolve errors. You generally don't write perfect code the first time through, and so the ability to diagnose bugs is a valuable skill to develop. All that being said, just because this information is incomplete doesn't mean that this tutorial is bad. The information it does cover is presented well, so there's definitely value there. I think it's a good starting point for absolute beginners, but if you choose to use the Brackeys How to Program in C# tutorial, just make sure that you do some additional reading or viewing regarding the things that I mentioned earlier, especially if you plan to go on to developing games using Unity. Thank you for watching, and do remember to like the video if you thought it was useful.